Today, I'm going to go over Loopback, a powerful Mac application that lets you take full control of audio on your computer. This app allows you to take audio from one application and pass it into another. It allows you to combine multiple sources of audio and inputs and route them anywhere on your computer. This is like having a powerful studio mixing board right in your computer. Even though this is a Mac-only application, there are similar Windows applications. And after this video, hopefully you'll get some ideas on how you can use it. Let's get into it. If you're starting to do more online presentations or productions, audio is one of, if not the most important part of a presentation. I find that an audience is more forgiving for mediocre video quality, but bad audio quality can be very frustrating. As we start to do more of these complicated productions, it's easy to quickly lose control of audio. My name is Patrick, and this is Everyday Tech. Everyday tech for everyday people. In this video, I'm going to show you how I use Loopback. This is not necessarily a tutorial on it, but although I am going to show you some hands-on on how I set it up, but you can find or search plenty of tutorials on it online. Loopback allows me to take any audio source on my computer, whether it's coming from a microphone, an application, or even another computer, and route them to any other output that's connected to my computer. So today we're talking about production, whether it's live, online, or even hybrid. This also applies to online meetings on Zoom or Teams or any other online platform. So if you're doing an online presentation using a meeting software and you want to bring in some background music, Loopback is the way to do it. So here's a scenario. Let's say I'm doing an online presentation or show, and I want to use Zoom because I'm going to bring in a guest. And let's say I want to bring in some background music, especially for the intro or the outro. And let's say I'm going to use Spotify to play the music. So you can use basically any software here. Instead of Zoom, you can use Ecamm on a Mac, vMix on a PC, you can even use Microsoft Teams, etc., even Skype, right? Instead of Spotify, let's say I want to use VLC Player, I can play a clip on the podcast app or Apple Music, any other kind of music player here. The point is, I'm able to do all this audio routing right from my computer. So let me show you how I set it up. Okay, so now we're in Loopback, and I have these two different virtual devices that I'm not going to touch because I use them for other programs, but we're going to create a new virtual device here. And remember, I want to be able to create a scenario where I can bring in music, but also I want to be able to use the microphones I have right now. So let's call this Zoom meeting with music. Okay. Now, I'm not going to go over pass-through in this video, so we're just going to delete that for now, but I'm going to bring in my different sources. Now, I have Spotify here because I have it running already, but you can go ahead and select an application from your Finder as well. But since I already have it here, I'm going to go Spotify. So that's coming in as a source, but I'm also going to add another device. I need to add the microphone that I'm using because I want to be able to speak into it as well while the music is playing. So in this case, I have my Evo 4 here, and now it's coming in. So now I have Spotify and my Evo 4 working here. And this audio device is called Zoom Meeting with Music. So that means in Zoom, I can select that as we go. So let's jump into Zoom and let me show you how I get this done. Okay, so here we are in Zoom. And right now I need to select the new audio source that we created, which is called Zoom Meeting with Music. So I'm going to go into my preferences here. I know you can do this the other way, but right now I have a different input that I created before, but now we're going to use the Zoom Meeting with Music. So now that's created there. We're going to go ahead and exit out of this. And now I'm going to show you the recorded Zoom meeting. I'm going to record the Zoom meeting really quick and show you what the audience will hear on their end. So now we are using Zoom, and this is the output that people will see. But right now, you won't hear the music right now because I didn't hit play on Spotify yet. But let's say I'm doing an intro and I want to bring in some music. I'm going to hit play and then slowly fade up the volume on Spotify. So right now I'm going to slowly fade up the music and just kind of give my intro. I'm Patrick. This is Everyday Tech. Everyday Tech for everyday people. And let's say I want to do an outro. I hope you enjoyed this. Please like and subscribe. And then you can fade that on. And then I can slowly fade it all the way down. So I do have to manually fade it up and down, but there are other programs where you can do the fading and fading out, fading in and fading out automatically as well. So I'm starting to do a lot more hybrid type events. I've done 3 Zoom weddings where I broadcast the couple's wedding on Zoom. I'm starting to do weekly hybrid church meetings where we have a small group meeting together in person, but a majority of the people are still on Zoom online. In both these types of events, I've been required to use multiple microphones. Loopback allows me to combine and use all these microphones simultaneously or separately and switch between the two. In Zoom and other meeting softwares and other presentation softwares, you can switch between different audio sources, but you do have to click through. But also, you're not able to use these simultaneously. Now, if you're using multiple mics simultaneously, one thing to watch out for is potential delays because of different types of microphones that potentially there, but that's just something to watch out for. So for church meetings, I have a USB microphone that's for the general congregation. Then I have a microphone that's connected to me because even though I'm behind the desk doing the production, another part of my job is to make the announcements. So when it comes time for me to make the announcements, I can turn on my microphone and turn off the USB microphone that's for the rest of the congregation. The point is I'm able to have full control of all the inputs that are connected to my computer, whether it be a USB microphone, a microphone that's plugged in directly into my inline port of my computer, or even from an audio interface. Another great thing about Loopback is that I can monitor any of the audio through any of the outputs. So let's say I want to monitor what's coming through the microphones in real time. Now I can use any of the outputs that's connected to my computer. So on my Mac Mini setup here, I have at least 4 to 5 different outputs I can possibly route the audio to. First, I have my CalDigit dock. There's a headphone jack there that I can route the audio to. Or there's even a digital Toslink digital output connector there that I can route the audio to. My Mac Mini here has the built-in speakers, which I wouldn't recommend because they're not the greatest speakers. There's a headphone jack in the back where I can route the audio to. On my audio interface here, I can route audio to there as well. And I can route audio to all these places all at once as well. So that's kind of a cool feature of using Loopback, to help you route audio, not just from another to another application, but to any output that's connected to my computer here. Here in Loopback, I'm gonna show you how we can bring in multiple microphones, and then I'll also show you the multiple output or monitors that you can add to your audio interface here. So I'm gonna bring in, let's see, my Evo 4 that I'm using right now, and you can see the levels there. But I can also use a USB microphone. So I have the ever famous Yeti stereo microphone here. That's a USB microphone. And it's right here on my desk right next to me. And you can see both of them are receiving a signal all at the same time. So I can easily turn them on and off here. I don't have it selected in my recording here. So that's why you don't hear it turning on and off. I'm using this audio interface up here. Now to the monitors, this is how we monitor the sound coming out, or you can output the audio to any other device as well. So if I have speakers hooked up to my, let's say PA speakers, amplifying speakers hooked up to my audio interface, I can select my Evo 4 as the output here, and then I can turn that on and off. I don't have anything selected or connected to it right now. I can also do my external headphones, which is what's connected to my computer speakers here. I'm not going to turn that on right now because I'm afraid of some echo. And I can also use the built-in Mac Mini speakers. I can do all of those at the same time, so I can have multiple outputs at the same time for my audio. So one of the things I mentioned in my previous video concerning the Audient Evo 4 USB interface is how the sound gets routed. Now, everything that goes into input 1 usually goes into the left ear, left channel. Anything in input 2 goes into the right channel. Now, this is great for recording because you can control the different levels of the different channels in post-processing, but this is not always necessarily the best thing for live events or online events or even online meetings. So you can use Loopback to do this. So basically anything that comes in either from input 1 or input 2, if it goes into input 1, I make sure I send it to both the left and the right channel. Anything into input 2, I make sure to send it to the left and right channel. So let me show you how I get this done. Here in Loopback, I'm going to show you how I route the input channels into both left and right output channel here. So now I'm going to select my Evo 4. Now I have the microphone I'm using right now is using input 2. And as you can see, input 2 is going into the right channel there. But I want it to go to both channels. So what I'm going to do is just simply click my mouse right there, drag and drop it into the left channel there. So now it's going into both channels. Even though I don't have anything in input 1 right now, I'm going to do the same thing for input 1, drag and drop that one into the right channel. So now input 2 on my audio interface is going both to the left and to the right channel. And so this is what I want mainly for my online meetings as well. Now, for sure, there are a lot more complicated different types of routing you can do, but it's a matter of just dragging and dropping the different routes that you want to do all the way to the monitoring here as well. So I can have different places, different microphones route to different outputs. And so you can start to get very complicated with these things, but it's very simple, a very simple drag and drop of the routing itself. Another case I'll just mention and not demo is using applications that support virtual cameras, such as Ecamm, VMix, or OBS. Now, if you don't know what a virtual camera is, it allows you to bring the video feed from these types of presentation softwares and bring them into another presentation software or meeting software, such as Zoom. So why would you do this? Well, OBS, VMix, and Ecamm supports doing lower thirds and graphics, but Zoom doesn't. So if you use these presentation softwares, you can use a virtual camera to bring them into Zoom. The problem is it only brings in the video feed and not the audio. So Loopback allows you to just route the audio that's coming from these presentation software and bring them into other programs such as Zoom. So these are some ways I use Loopback. Again, on Windows, there are equivalent apps out there. VB Audio comes to mind as a very popular one. But if you're using Loopback, let me know how you use it. If you found this video helpful, give it a like and consider subscribing. Until the next one, see ya.